Panel number three. Hello, YouTubers. This is Noobifier. If you're a fan of the channel, you're going to know that I love any time when I have an opportunity to review a brand new piece of gear for you, especially if that is a prototype. I've already reviewed panel one from VIRPIL and we'll look at panel number two in a little bit, but today is the release of the Sharka50 panel, the third one to be released. I've been using and testing it for about a month now, and for the remainder of the video, I'm going to simply refer to it as panel number three. Let's begin. VIRPIL is a Belarusian controller manufacturer who entered the market in 2016. They've regularly released new products that are very well suited in flight and space flight markets. We as sim enthusiasts are very lucky. We have a wide range from virtual, tactile, audible, and other input devices, and all of these help to improve our experience. Some are pure function, such as the Stream Deck, but some are very highly specialized, such as Game Glass. And then there are others, such as the ones being reviewed today, that offer a little bit more, or something different. The price point of this comes with a greater build, thick software support, and bringing you closer to not only having the correct binding available, but having it look and work like it's supposed to. So VIRPIL reached out to the community through a contest asking for design submissions. The best were chosen with a promise that they would be built. Now, mid-November 2021, all three winners are released. The case is metal, powder-coated black with soft, clean edges. The feet are grippy rubber on metal legs that can be removed for many mounting options. The panel and throttle sits on the same physical case so they can be joined up or mounted easily. VIRPIL has their complete lineup of mounting options, and Monster Tech is also ready with their own desk mounts, chair mounts, chairs, and sim pits. Both are great at different price points, offering different user flexibility. I'm going to start by looking at the construction inside, as this is more interesting. You get to see fit and finish components and maybe determine longevity. Seeing how wires are pathed inside will identify if those wires are away from being pinched or worn out. You can see how easily parts in here might be replaced with plug termination buttons instead of soldering. The right to repair is a real thing, and it's nice to see great modular construction. And I'm going to say, the red on black. Striking. Like, really, really pretty. I was expecting blue like the others, but the red made me smile. Also, I wanted to point out again, you can see that there are very few wires. The main sections are each on their own daughter board, and as I said, if you needed to repair, it would be reasonable to think that they could send a replacement part, and with a bit of time, you could have it replaced all by yourself. No glue, no solder, fantastic. No shipping, back and forth, no downtime. Such a good idea. Panel 3 is unique from the throttles and the other two panels. Unlike those, which are fairly generalized, this one is very specifically labeled, and why VIRPIL decided to call it Sharka50, intended to be used with their helicopter collective. So now I'm going to be going over the panel layout, but in testing, I couldn't help notice something. If I didn't already own a throttle or another panel, I might just get this one if I were on a budget. It's not a throttle, but it has four axes, right? So could this be used as an Airbus throttle? I don't see why not, but it's important to know that there are no bumps or steps all the way from 0 to 100 on all four. Where this gets really exciting is in Star Citizen. These can be used to set mining laser output. They could be used for zoom, acceleration limit, power output, speed limit. Yes, yes, yes. This is basically the closest thing that I need for Star Citizen if I'm looking for a pure tactile controller. You have four analog levers, which can be two engines, flaps, and gears. It can be whatever you like, and in my opinion as a gamer who plays many types of sims, I keep finding things that these work well with. Nice and simple too, with a smaller footprint than having two or more of these. They included a series of colored and shaped lever tips. In VR, you can feel the shape and position. You can quickly feel the round and smooth, oval, bumpy up, or bumpy down. They're also color-coded, and again, more options if you're using monitors. Between these three, plus the throttle, there's basically no excuse to run out of buttons or to not have those bindings exactly where you want them. I feel they're priced very well for what they are, and yes, not everyone will be able to justify owning one. Just remember to consider how much and how often you play and then divide that cost against that time. To get this panel to function is no different than any other product. Use the included USB wire directly to your PC or the auxiliary wire to slave it to another, and that would free up a USB port. Software does firmware, lets you test functions, and lets you work on some pretty custom functions that I plan to speak about in an upcoming video. From bottom to top, there's a low-high 2 position, HEAPI 2 position, a 3 position labeled long, medium, short, a 2 position for manual and automatic. There's a 5 position rotary navigation, fail, manual, fix, and move. I tried to identify the two-position HMS and off, but that acronym is used so frequently in the Navy that any search drew a blank. Please comment in the comments if you know what that's supposed to be. Help us out. Thanks in advance. And that's the same with auto and TS. Laser off to position and then a momentary reset illuminated button. E1 is labeled brightness. E1 is a rotary encoder with push, customizable RGB momentaries. These are so useful. There's a total of 10, but 8 of them are labeled B1 through B8. Another's labeled direction, and there's an encoder E2 that's also near that with a push. 3 non-illuminated momentaries for start-stop auxiliary power unit. There's a 3-position switch for left, right, and neutral, and a 3-position switch for start, crank, and neutral. Master arm on-off toggle, and your 4 analog levers. I think you can see what I was saying at the beginning of the video, that this offers a little bit more of everything for everyone, and if you didn't absolutely require a real throttle grip, this might work well enough to get the job done. I'm going to make a short announcement here that I'm probably retiring from the military after 30 years, and the plan is to focus on making content both on YouTube and live streaming. So with that, I'm going to be speccing out a custom rig that'll work with DCS, fixed and rotor, Star Citizen, and driving. This will not alter the YouTube focus on Star Citizen, but I mention it mainly because you will be in the future able to see firsthand how I use and configure all of this gear, and then of course, have your questions answered live. Twitter or Discord is the best way to see where stuff is going on, and I'm really excited to focus full-time on content. So hopefully this gives you exactly all the information that you need to make an informed choice. I like the others, but this one is specifically cool, covering many more features in one panel. And I feel that this sums up what I wanted to say about it. It's pretty expensive, but it's overbuilt and really high quality, both internally and externally. So parting thoughts, if it looks like it would be what you need, add it to your personal setup, and I can vouch for this as the real deal. Don't forget, if you already own a panel, VIRPIL is offering a discount. And finally, people in the comments sometimes decide to chirp on me for being unnecessarily positive in my reviews, but this really has to do with the quality and level of products that I often look at, right? Something this costly shouldn't have many faults in build or implementation. Thank you very much for spending your time with me. I love playing with new gear, so please suggest any that you might like me to look at. Fly safe, and I'll see you in the verse.